Hello, good evening. Thanks for joining. Thank you, thanks for joining. I'm going to finish this now because I'll be doing another pastel later on. This one here. So I'm just adding some of the lightest lights and the darkest dark. Thanks for the likes. And I decided not to put the earrings because a lot of my followers commented in Instagram also not to put the earrings because it's very rare for Frida to add earrings. So I decided not to put earrings. So right now I'm just adding the highlights, and then later on I'll be adding some of the darkest darks. So this is only red pastel and charcoal black and white, so almost three pigment. Thank you so much, Emily. Yeah. Thank you. Thanks for the likes. Thank you. Thanks for the likes, Emily. So so that's what I'm doing right now. I'm just make sure all the highlights are in place. Just a few final detailing. There you go. Thanks, Queen All Night. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thanks, Emily. So I'm just fixing the shadows because the shadows will make everything pop, and all the reflection here, reflected lights. So I'm just defining that right now, and then maybe I'll put some more dark on that side and then I'll be done. And I'll be doing another one here. There's one painting at the back, so I'll be doing that in an hour. So this is almost done. Thanks for sharing. Thank you. So this is a red chalk pastel. So I'm just defining some of the dark here. There you go. So just pushing some of the shadows here, the main core shadows. And beside what we call Terminator, there's one shadow there you go, and here. So I'm just defining the shadow, this one here also. If you have some technical question, you can ask me. I have to blend this. Yeah, you can ask some questions if you're an artist and want to know the materials I'm using. So I'm just fixing all my shadows. I think that should be darker. So you have this dark here. And then dark there. What is it? Thank you so much. It's actually smiling at me. Thank you. I'll be adding some more dark here. Should be almost the same as dark on that part here, there. So it's just like a balancing act. The lights and your midtones and the darks should be also balanced. To darken this one, and I have to make sure the reflected light's there. This one is lighter than that one. There you go. We have this cheekbone here. Okay, I have to darken some of this part here also. Thanks for the likes, thanks for the follow, thanks for the share. Thanks for the share. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Queen, I couldn't read. There you go. Thanks, Queen. One thing nice is only basically one color is red, and then you only use the black charcoal to darken it, and you have the white pastel to lighten it. So technically, it's only one color. So this is a good exercise if you're going to painting, because you'll learn how to distinguish correct values from the lights to darks, which is very important when you do your portraits. Let me just take out some of the dirt. The challenging part here is the reflected lights in the skin, like this one here. And she has, yeah, it's one color. It's only sanguine, red chalk. There you go, it's sanguine. So it's only red, and then you will add the charcoal or the black, your black pencil, charcoal pencil. And then your white pastel for the highlights. That's it. And then your paper is warm gray. The paper itself is already warm. So there's another sanguine here. It's called sanguine. Yeah, so it's also red, see? And then you have darker red. So a variety of red I'm using. See, this is cooler. It's actually Indian red. They call Indian red. Yeah. So you have darker, you have lighter. So that's how you control your value. When I say value, I'm talking about this one. We call that value, the tone. From dark to light. So just using your red chalk plus your black and white, so you can expand your value from lighter to darker. So that's it. And this is a very vital exercise if you're going on to painting, because some artists will just immediately go to portrait painting without doing one color studies. And that's why they fail most of the time, because they don't understand values. So it's pretty much, before going to a full color painting or pastel, you should work on one color. You can start with black only and white, and then once you're okay with black and white, then you start with red, black and white. So imagine just one color. As long as you put your values correct, you're good. It's not actually the color. The important thing is the correct values. Especially this picture, you have so many shadows playing around. See, that's why I really have to highlight. You have shadows here. And there's a lot of reflection here, reflected lights. At that corner also, I don't know whether you can see. there's a reflection on that side, and then let me also darken this. There you go. And then lighter the underneath one. Thank you so much. Honey fuck, thank you so much. Because there's a reflection here, skin reflection. I think there's a soft light coming from this one. So that's why she has some reflection here, skin reflection. Go. Thank you. Thanks for the likes. Also, thanks for sharing my live. There you go. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, Rosanna. Muchas gracias. So I'm just so right now I'm just adding some of the darks. So my aim today is to add some of the darks and some of the lightest lights, because mostly the middle values are okay. And then that's it, we're done. Thanks for the follow. Thank you. Let me add some of the lights here. Thank you. Thanks for the likes. Also, thanks for the follow. So right now I'm just making sure all the lights are okay. And see. Adding some of the highlights. I don't really copy exactly what's in the picture. I'll try to interpret. So just adding some of the highlight. Just some of the highlight. Thanks for the follow. Thanks for the likes. So this is almost done. This is almost done. Thank you. So there you go. I'm just adding some of the lights. Now I have to push some dark here. If you have some technical question and you are an artist, you can ask me. It's okay. I'll teach for free. So what I'm doing right now is just pushing all my darks. What paint do you recommend for beginners? Watercolor. Depends on what you planning to do. Are you doing portraits, landscape, let me know. Because before you paint, you have to study how to draw. Start doing graphite, charcoal, and pastel. And then once you familiarize with that medium, and then you move to painting. And then it's up to you, basically, whether you want watercolor, acrylic, or oil paint. I tried everything. I'm also a watercolorist, but I prefer oil paintings. Some people, they like acrylic, but of all medium, I like oils. But my suggestion is, it depends on your direction of your painting. Is it landscape? If it is portraiture like this? So my suggestion is always learn how to draw. Draw with graphite, and then you move to charcoal. And then from there you move to pastel. Understand color theory, just a simple color theory, then you go to painting. Because if you go to painting immediately without understanding values, and it will be harder for you to paint properly. So first, understand values. Understand this one. This is value. Value is tone. Understand dark to light. And then paint only one color, like what I'm doing right now. Okay? Once you're good at understanding values in one color, like this one, I'm using only red plus black and white. And then it's easier for you to paint. Hold on, I have to get something. Hold on. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, so you really have to start doing, before you go to painting, you really have to do one like this one. That's charcoal. Okay, that means this is only charcoal, that's only black. There's no white. I use eraser for the lights. So once you're familiar with just charcoal, and then you move to pastel. Okay, like this one, the red one. So once you're okay with this, you move to pastel. Just one color. This is another pastel. That's another pastel work. But this is almost full color pastel. So this process you really have to go through before going to painting. Because if you jump to painting without understanding the values, it's very hard. So it's not really the color, it's about the value. Once you nail the value of the paste using just one color, you'll be good. And then you can move to painting. Okay. So that's an oil paint. This is another red chalk. Okay, this is another red chalk. This is another painting. Oil paint. Okay. So how did I do that? Because I started correctly. I don't just paint immediately. I really have to study how to draw. Understand values. Understand the values, this one. Okay, so once you understand the values, you start with charcoal or graphite. You start with charcoal. Once you master the charcoal or graphite, master this one, values, okay? It's not the color, it's the values and the drawings and the edges. So once you master this one, then you move to red chalk. You move to this one, red chalk or brown. And then you move to painting. So those are the paintings I did. I paint on papers. See? Now it's easier because you understand values. You can put your colors, you understand values, it's easier. You know how to draw, then it's easier. And then whatever medium you use, whether you use acrylic, watercolor, but for me, oil for me is easier. I tried acrylic, I don't like it. Another oil paint. Okay. So learn how to draw, especially if you're into portraiture. There's a lot of resources online that teach you how to draw properly. Understand the eyes, understand the nose, the lips, ears. You really have to like memorize the form of the ears. It's a lot of work, but if you like what you're doing, it's your passion, then it's very rewarding. So that's it. That's the if you have some more question, and then you try acrylic, just buy a few colors. If you like it, you also try oil paint, so at least you have some comparison. One thing with watercolor, if you don't know what you're doing, you'll mess up because the medium is hard if you're into portraiture. But everything relies on understanding values, understanding the values and the drawings. Everything is there. No, it's actually Frida Kahlo. Frida Kahlo. Okay. Let me just move the highlight here. Sorry, I don't understand Spanish, I'm sorry. I don't know how to translate this one. Translate, okay. Ah, the other painting. Ah, no, the other painting, that's my friend, the other girl. Let me see. Where is it? The other painting, where is it? This one? This is my friend. She's an artist also from Ukraine. Another charcoal. Okay. So that's another charcoal. That's why just doing one color will really train you how to see values. Anyway, let me continue. Let me just refine the shadow here. Thank you. Thanks for the like. Thanks for the follow. Hey, Jennifer, kamusta? Jennifer Malong. Kamusta? Thanks for the follow. Thank you. Thanks for the likes. Okay, let me fix the reflection, skin reflection. Because there's a lot of skin reflection here. Thanks for the likes. Yeah, there's a lot of skin reflection because there's a strong light here, and then some light is reflecting from this side. So as you can see, thanks for the follow, thank you. Yeah, anyway, I'm almost done. Almost done with this painting, so I'm doing another one, the one here at the back. I haven't finished one of my paintings. Okay. So right now I'm just balancing all the reflected light on the skin. Thank you, thanks for the likes. Okay, let me fix the lights again on the left side. Go. Because there's really a heavy light here. One here also, some of the highlights, some of the heavy lights. One there. There you go. And there's reflection here underneath. Plus the shadow. Thank you, thanks for joining. If you can you tell me where are you? Where are you coming from? I'm actually in Los Angeles. Hollywood area. No, it's pastel. I'm using pastel. Sanguine. And sanguine. And then carbon pencil. And charcoal pencil. So it's called called Trouis in France, meaning three pencil, okay? Red, white, and black. So that's why it's three pencil. So I use red, black carbon, and charcoal to darken, and white to lighten. So it's only three colors. So right now I'm adding some white on the lightest part. No problem, Hanifa. Any question, just let me know. So, it's just red. Basically red. Okay. Sometimes they call this red chalk portrait. Sometimes they call it sanguine, because the red chalk or the red pastel is called sanguine, but it's actually red ochre, or sometimes you can use Venetian red, English red, French red. Any red earth. In painting, they do that also in paintings. Yeah, so I'm almost done, because I'll be doing another portrait at the back. There's one there, which I haven't finished for like, oh my. I think for 6 months now, I haven't finished it. I think this is okay. Let me just push that. Yeah, I think this is okay. This will be good for the meantime. Thank you. Thanks for the likes. Thank you. Thanks, Anipa. Yeah, I think this will be okay for the meantime. Let me just work on the shadow. Yes, there's a coarse shadow there. Thanks for the likes, Anipa. Thank you. Any question? Any material question? Things, the materials I'm using, you just let me know. Yeah, okay, let me just define this coarse shadow here. It's very challenging to do because of so many play on light, so many play on shadows, and the reflection, skin reflection here. I don't know whether you see that. Oh yeah, correct. You start with the graphite. That's the thing to do, and then always understand the values, okay? Know your values and your drawings. And then once you're okay with graphite, I'll show you my graphite. Okay, hold on. So this is a graphite, and then I just add some white pastel on the highlights, okay? This is my daughter. So you start with this graphite. Learn how to draw properly, okay? Understand the eyes, the nose, the mouth, okay? So those are graphite. See, can you see how close it is? Yeah, and I add some white on the highlight, white pastel. Okay? Another one, my son-in-law. See, this is my son-in-law. That's also graphite, okay? See all the lines? See the lines? Okay. See the eyes? And see the mouth? And then the teeth. It's very simple. It's not really hyper-realistic, okay? And then once you're okay with graphite, then you move to charcoal. Again, you study again. When you're doing charcoal, you should study again, understand the values and the drawings. I'll show you my charcoal. Where's my charcoal? Okay, hold on, huh? Where's the charcoal? So that's charcoal. So from graphite, you move to charcoal. Okay. So from graphite, you move to charcoal. This is charcoal pencil. Okay. See, it's charcoal on paper. Okay. Again, learn how to draw. Drawing is very important. And understand your values. Okay. Once you're okay with your charcoal, then move to red chalk. Okay? So graphite, charcoal, then move to red chalk. This is only red. You just add black to darken and white to lighten. After that, same thing. This is also three color. This is also pastel. But look at the texture. This is three color also. But this one is yellow, red, white, plus black. Okay? And then once you're okay with this, then you move to painting. Okay, so you really have then you move to painting. Okay? You move to paintings. Okay, move to paintings. It's easier now when you paint because you understand your values. You just learn how to color. Oh, there's a lot of good pastels right now. You can buy Carbotello. New pastel is cheap. Okay. New pastels. They're cheap, but they're good. See? New pastel. I also have Rembrandt. This is really good. Okay. And then one of the expensive is Sennelier pastels. Quite expensive. So okay. Hope you understand. Hi, Paul Lolo. Oh my God. My granddaughter is here. Kamusta? How are you? Okay, I have to drop this painting. I have to continue my other pastel. Just hold on, huh? I have to get some of my materials ready. Okay, so let me just show you so that's the reference photo. Okay, originally it's black and white, okay? That's the original picture. And then I changed the clothes. Do you recognize? I changed it. I used this clothes here. Okay? Not this one. I changed it. Okay? And supposed to be I have to put some earrings. But a lot of comments I received, even in Instagram. There's another one. Frida, supposed to put these earrings there, but a lot of people are commenting no need because it's very rare. Mostly Frida has earrings, but there you go. So anyway, let me change my painting right now. I'll continue that. Let me work on my other pastel. Hold on, huh? Okay. Okay. Let me move this one, huh? Hold on. I need to finish this one, this other painting. Okay. Yeah, I need to finish this one. Let me change some of my pencils. So this is full color now. Okay. And just to show you the original picture. So that's the original picture. That's her. She's my follower on Instagram, and I asked her whether I can paint her. Okay. That's her. So this is the original one. I just sharpen it. Okay, and then edit in Photoshop. That's her. And then some of the reference photo. Use both. You can do. For me, I'm doing both. I'm doing dry brush. I'm doing direct pastel. If you can see, I can show you closer. Can you see the pencil? See? You can see the pencil there. So it's you can do whatever technique necessary. As long as you get the correct values. So anyway, let me So I changed the clothes. I changed it because that's the original clothes she has. Okay, and I added this laurel on her. And I changed it to a Filipina dress. So the title of this, because the title of this painting is Mestiza. Mestiza. Okay, and I have here my volcano from Philippines, and this one is a European scenery here, because Mestiza is mixed, it's like Eurasian and Philippines, it's a mixed race. So anyway, let me just, because there's a problem with the hand. Okay, let me just fix the hand. It looks swollen here, so I need to do some changes. Just get all my pastels. Hold on, huh? Okay, let's do this. There you go. I just need to touch up the hands. work on the shadow. So if you have a question, you can ask me as long as I know the answer. The paper I'm using is, if I do a charcoal or pastel, it's always canson, canson mitiente. Thank you. Thanks for the likes. No, I already done Frida. I'm doing another painting. This is Frida. Okay. I'm doing another painting. I already done with Frida. Okay. So don't tell me no way. So I'm doing another project. I'm already done with the Frida. This is Nazli. Her name is, okay, I'll show you. That's her. She's my Instagram friend, Nazli. And I asked her whether I can paint her. This is her, she's a model. Okay. And then this is the original picture. And then I added a lot of things from my artwork. I changed it. So right now I'm just finishing this one. Let me put Frida on the side. Hold on, huh? Let me just move there. So people can see that Frida is on the side. Let me zoom out. Anyway, because I need to finish this one. Okay, hold on, huh? How can I change the thank you. How to change my title? Okay, hold on, huh? How to change my title, because I'm not working with Frida now. Topics. Hello. How to change my title? Oh my God, how to change. Okay, let me pause for a while, okay? I no need. Okay, anyway. Anyway, Thanks for joining. Thank you so much. If you just joined, I already finished doing Frida Kahlo. So, I'm doing another anyway, thanks for the likes. Thanks for the follow. Where's my... Thank you. Just if you're just log in, I already finished Frida Kahlo's artwork, so I'm doing another one right now. Oh, thank you so much. Thanks, Jojoro. Thank you so much. I just finished one pastel a while ago, the portrait of Frida Kahlo. I don't know. I might go back tomorrow and recheck because my eyes are tired already looking at the same artwork for couple of hours. So normally I need to like rest my eyes and look for another artwork. So right now I'm working on this one. Quite long. If you ask me the number of hours I already spent on this artwork, maybe 30-40 hours. I don't work straight. Sometimes I'll work like 4 hours and then go back for a few days. Yeah, maybe around 40 hours. Oh, thank you so much. Thanks. Thanks, Jojo. I appreciate it so much, okay? Thank you so much. So my artwork of Frida is already done. So right now I'm just doing this. Thank you. Oh yeah. I'm selling it. It's not print out the original artwork. If you will scan through my videos, I have a few of them for sale. But this one, it will be exhibited on June next year. So I'm not selling it right now. But I have a few on my videos. You can check. Thank you, thanks for the likes. So this is an original art piece. The model is one of my followers in Instagram. That's her, Nazli. That's her Instagram name. So I just ask her whether I can paint her, and then she told me, yeah, okay. So I decided to get this picture and then added the laurel. But the idea is actually based on this one. That's the idea. So almost, that's why I have this, that's the idea. Basically, and then I just changed the background. I changed the clothes, her clothes. Okay, so let's see. Oh, thank you so much. Thanks, Tony. Thank you so much. Oh yeah, good morning. It's already 12 something. Thank you. Yeah, I try to finish this one because I just finished Frida Kahlo's portrait a while ago. So let me just put it down. Yeah. So I just finished this one, Frida Kahlo, a while ago. But this is only red chalk. Everything is red. Red and black plus white. So this is done. So I'll see whether I can do some more tomorrow. Yeah. That's her. Oh yeah. Thank you so much, Tony. Yeah, so just red and black and white. So I'm done with this. I don't know whether I haven't signed it. That means I'm still thinking whether I can do some more things. So thanks, Valentina. Thank you so much. Yeah. There you go. So I'll see tomorrow. Maybe I can do some more things. But I just keep in view for a while. Sometimes my eyes are tired, so I'm doing this one. This pastel. Thank you so much. Thanks, Valentina. So I'm just finishing this pastel. My eyes already tired looking at Frida Kahlo. So sometimes I have to shift my focus to another. So just to show you again, that's the original picture, and then I just added laurel on her head, and then I changed the clothes. The concept is coming from that picture. That's the concept. Okay, that's the idea. So I made some changes, and that's it. Yeah. And as you can see, I added this background here. Because my title of my work is actually called Miss Tisa. So she's wearing a Filipina dress. Okay? So she's a Miss Tisa. She's a mixed race of Filipino and European. That's why the background here is Europe. And this one is Philippines. This is the famous Mayung volcano. Okay? So that's the idea. So you have two world here. You have Philippines and Europe, and she's also a mestiza. She's a mixed race. So anyway, that's the concept. So I'm just refining this work. Thank you so much, Javier. Thank you so much. I'm just expanding the values. Thank you so much. Yeah. So it's a mixed race. Yeah. So Europe here on the left, and this is the Philippines. this is a famous mayong volcano. I try to cut the So that's the concept. That's the main concept. And I added the laurel on top of the head. Thank you. So anyway, just to let the new one who was joined, I already finished my Frida Kahlo red chalk. So it's done. So it's all red. Yeah. I'll show you how if you can see, there's no sharp edges on my work. It's all soft edges. It's spumato, they call it spumato. See the edges, it's all lost edges, very soft. There are only selected items that are sharp. Yeah, everything is soft. Okay? Same true when I paint. My painting. Yeah, edges are soft also. Another one, another painting. You can see, there's no really like very, very sharp. It's all soft and like this one, you can see the brush strokes. She's also an artist. Okay. So those things. So I try not to do a hyper realistic. I cannot do that. And another one, another pastel. Pastel pencil, actually, you can see. You can definitely see the pencils there. But when you go far, it changes. And I love this charcoal. My charcoal. It's on paper. Yeah. Very, very few are really sharp, mostly are soft edges. See, do you see how the edges are soft? And then I also have, I'll show my graphite. This is graphite. So graphite. Yeah, I added some white pastel. Yeah, the teeth are very hard to do. The gums and the mouth, that's very hard. This is graphite. Anyway, that's my daughter. Yeah, so anyway, that's how I work. So let me continue this one. So Thank you. I need to darken this part a little bit. I need to push this value darker. Thanks for the follow, thanks for the likes, thank you. Thank you so much. If you have some technical question, you can ask me. Because I don't mind. I'll teach for free, so there you go. If you just join me, I already finished doing Frida Kahlo, so this is another painting. I already finished Frida Kahlo, so I have to do another one. I might go back in a while to retouch, to work on Frida. Sometimes my eyes are tired. Hey, Romero, kamustasa? Salamat, thanks for joining. Thank you, salamat. Yeah, tapos ko na kasi yung Frida Kahlo ko, ito. But I'll go back later. Ha ha ha, grabe sa pag Romero. Tagalog. Hindi ko alam pangalan mo eh. So, I might go back here for a while because my eyes already tired. So, to finish because I haven't signed it. Normally, once I'm contented with my artwork, I normally sign. Okay? So, my eyes are tired, so I have to look for another things to do. I'll go back to Frida in a while. So while resting my eyes. So anyway, hi. Oh, thank you so much, Holly. So anyway, this model is a good friend. And let me just show you the original picture. That's the original picture. Okay. And this one, I just added the laurel on top. Okay. And then I changed the clothes. I changed it. That's her. Okay. Thanks for the follow. Yeah, I changed the clothes to a Filipina dress. And then the background here is Mayung Volcano from the Philippines. Nagpaparinig. And then this is Europe on the left side. So I haven't finished the background. I'm still working basically on her. On her face. So right now what's that? Let me add some highlight. Good night. Thank you. Okay, need to add some highlight there. And some highlight here. Romero. Andiyan ka pa, Romero. Highlight there. And highlight here. Let me get okay. Yeah, tsaka lang ha. Baka wala na akong kausap eh. No work today. Oops. Aye. So later on, I'll go back and work on Frida Kahlo. I think I already have a press eyes to see some of the error, if there's some errors. Okay, I think that's it for a meantime. Let me work on Frida again. Hold on, huh? Okay, hold on. Let me just let me work on Frida Kahlo again. Let me just close this painting. I don't want it to be damaged. Okay. Okay. Let me work on this so I can finish it tonight. Okay, hold on. It won't go up. Hold on. Let me just stick that out. There you go. Thank you, Pei. Yeah, okay, let me finish Frida now. So I can sign it. Okay, let me just keep all my reference. Let's see. Ay, walang hard lines. Yeah, you really start with soft lines. Everything is soft. You only put your hard lines on the last part. Kasi we seldom like we put agad yung hard lines eh. So don't do that. So you start with everything is soft like gauze. Like a ghost edges, they call it. So yun ang technique doon. Okay, so what I'm doing now is to add the dark. You can see I'm adding now the dark. Thank you so much. Thank you. So that's what I'm doing right now. I'm posing now the dark. So just adding the darks. Hold on. It's hard to just call us safe, yeah. So if you have questions on technical matters, I'll just show you again the closer look. See? Everything is blur. If you can see, that's how I work. I seldom put sharp lines. See? All my edges are soft. That's how it looks at far. See, there's no sharp. See, if you go closer, it's all blur and soft. So it give you that atmosphere. So okay. That one, two. And then this one here. No, I don't have a store right now. I'm working on my online store because I don't do prints. If you want to check, I have videos on my TikTok where what artwork I'm selling right now. But I'm doing my own website wherein I can sell the paintings I did because I already have a couple of them on sale. Let me see, hold on. Right now I don't have online store. I'm putting up an online store. So just follow my TikTok and Instagram. I think before Christmas it will be done, or hopefully before New Year. But on my TikTok, I have some videos on what artwork I'm selling. This Frida, I'm selling it. Thank you so much, Teresa. Yeah, thank you so much. I'm still working on my price point. You DM me later so I can return back your inquiry. Because I'm trying to make a good price, especially this coming Christmas. So I might include the free shipping also. Thanks for your inquiry. Thank you, Teresa. Yeah, I'll check your profile. I might message you later, or you can message me also so I can return. Yeah. Then I send some pictures of what artwork I'm selling. Thank you, Teresa. Thanks for your support. I really appreciate it. When I started TikTok like 2 years ago, I didn't know that I will have some followers. So yeah. So right now I'm really adding. The lightest light. That's how I work. I normally put the lightest and the darkest last. And again, those artists are listening. Let me see. This point in my life that I stopped for almost 20 years. I'm already old, just to let you know. I'm already almost 60 years old. Anyway, I started my doing portrait professionally from 1986 to 1989, so 3 years. That's professionally. I started studying portrait around 1982. Okay, so it took me 4 years to really learn, and then 86 I started my own small shop in Manila, and then but 1990 I went to Singapore overseas to work as a graphic designer, and then everything stopped. I never went back to painting again. It's only in May of 2020 when I went back to drawing and painting. So if you calculate, maybe total, maybe 10 years, 8 years. Because there's like almost 20 years gap. It's almost from 1990 to 2020. How many years is that? There's few in between that friends ask me to draw or paint for their for a gift, but that's very rare. So yeah. So on 2020 during COVID, my wife, when she's still alive, she actually passed away a few months ago. So during COVID, she encouraged me to go back to painting, and that's what I did. I researched because of internet. I researched. Found artists that I wanted to follow and then enroll in their Patreon account, study some workshop, research about old master, and then that's it. So everything started back again in 2020. Oh, thank you so much, Paintbrush. Yeah. Yeah, see, my wife died last January of this year. So I'm still actually grieving. I'm still like, that's why sometimes I cannot paint. I just want to stay in one place quietly. It's very hard. Some more, she's my inspiration. She's the one who pushed me to go back to painting. Because professionally, I'm a graphic designer. I also do web design, food photography. So I have to relearn. I have to study again and then start practicing drawing. Because if you... Oh, thank you, Teresa. Yeah, thank you so much. That's true. She's my inspiration until now because she pushed me to excel. Plus, just to let you know, I'm a kidney transplant recipient. I was on dialysis for almost 10 years. And my wife is the one taking care of me for all those years that I was in the hospital. I have like how many surgeries in 9 years? I think I have 14 surgeries in almost 10 years that I'm on dialysis. My wife was there, my children too, and then yeah. So May of 2020, I had a new kidney. That's also the month when my wife pushed me to go back to painting, because I was recuperating at home and I'm not doing anything. So she told me, why did you go back to painting? You've been an artist all your life. And then, oh yeah. So I started researching again. Oh yeah, well, I have a drawing of her during the memorial service. I made one and I'm on a plan of doing another two more. But it's a challenge. I always cry every time I saw her face. So actually the charcoal pencil I made for her is not yet really done until now. It's almost done. But yeah, it always breaks my heart every time I saw. It's a challenge. But anyway, so what I'm doing right now is I'm actually expanding the values, okay? Those artists listening right now, I'm going to give you a quick tutorial, okay? If you're onto portraiture, especially if you want realism, my style is called traditional classical realism. It's not photographic, it's not hyperrealism. I was a hyper-realistic portrait, but I think when I become older, I shifted to more traditional. Anyways, if you're into portraiture and you want to really learn how to do portrait, the first thing you have to learn is learn how to draw. Okay, you really have to learn how to draw. Draw anything, draw your hand, draw anything, draw a flower, anything that you can find, draw bugs, just learn how to draw. Draw every time, that's the basic you must learn how. Because if you want to do portraiture and your drawing is very weak, then it's hard. Okay? After you learn how to draw, learn to understand how values work. Values, what's value? This is value, okay? You buy this one, this is value. Value is means from dark to light, okay? Not color, okay? Color is secondary. If you're going to ask me what's important, color, then value is important. Even though you're good in color, but you're bad in value, your painting will look bad. Okay, look at this. Okay, this is only red. But the values are correct. The drawings are correct. It looks better, even though I don't use color. Okay? Look at this charcoal. Okay? This is only charcoal. This is only black. But the values are correct. The values are correct. The drawings are correct. Okay? So, learn how to draw. Learn how to draw the eyes. Understand the anatomy of the eyes. Everything. There's a lot of tutorials online. Okay? Learn how to understand the nose, the lips, the ears, the whole head, because you're doing portrait. Learn how to draw that using graphite, okay? Graphite and then move to charcoal. Okay? Understand values. How do you look how you do your values on your portrait? Okay, I'll show you my graphite. Okay, graphite. Okay. This is graphite. For the graphite, I'm using Taunton Strathmore for the graphite. Okay? But for the pastel, I'm using Canson. Canson Mitiente. Let me write it down. I don't know whether I have. Let me write down, okay? Hold on. Canson
me.
That's the paper. Canson Mitiente paper. Okay? That's the paper. I use that for my charcoal, for my pastel, for my red chalk. So this is also Canson Mitiente paper. Okay, I try other paper, but I always stick with Canson because it's, for me, it's durable. Because if I use my brush, I use it very vigorously, okay, hard. And if your paper is not strong, it will damage. But this one, even though I put pressure on, like this one, I'm using a very small. I put pressure. See, I'm putting a lot of pressure right now. But the paper just grabbing my pigment. It's like there's, even though it's smooth, a little bit smooth, okay? It's just grabbing the pigment. It's stick there. So that's why I like this Canson. And it has a beautiful texture. It's like a skin texture. Okay, can you see the texture? All those small dotted. Okay. So I use Canson for everything, for my charcoal, for my pastel. Okay. So right now I'm using the charcoal straight, and the way I hold my pencil is like this. There's no law on how to hold it, but I like it this way because every time I rub it on the paper, it sharpens by itself. Okay, it sharpens. It's like you're hitting two birds in one stone. Okay? And then I just follow the hair strand. Okay? And then I rotate my pencil. That's how I work. Okay? So I put pencil here. Okay? So that's how I do it, and then I try to grab my brush just to soften it a little bit. Same here on where I did my pencil, and then when I use my brush, I also follow the hair strand. See, so it gives depth. Thank you, Teresa. Thank you so much. So. And then after that, where am I? Let me get. Okay, so I have this shading stamp. I like it so much. The reason is I can use that to add some highlight. Add some highlight there, okay. See? Thanks for joining. Thank you so much. Yeah. So and then I can add some highlight on that side, and then I can soften it. I have two sides. I have my light side. I have my dark side. Okay. So. If I want my dark side, I just flip my stamp and my light side here. Okay. See? is simple. And I'm not doing it like photographically. I don't like copy every strand. I just interpret what I see. We call that visual impression. And then you interpret it. It's like singing. You can sing Whitney Houston song, and then if you don't want to copy Whitney Houston song, you do it on your own style. It sounds better. So basically that's what I'm doing, especially if I'm copying a picture, unless it's in front of me. Sometimes even though it's in front of me, I wanted to interpret. See? So if I want to darken this part, thank you. Thanks for the likes. Thanks for the follow. Thank you so much. The hardest part is always the ears. Because you have those small muscles around. If you overwork on your ears, it looks awful. So this is only red chalk. It's called Truis. I think it's a French word for three pencil, because this is actually three pencil. It's only red, white, and black. Okay, so traditionally the red pencil, they call it sanguine. That's how they call it, sanguine pencil. That's the name, sanguine. There you go. Yeah. And I also have sanguine here. Sanguine. So and then there's another one. This is also another pastel, three colors also, but this is yellow, red, and black. Okay. And yes, my paintings this is the paintings it's painted on paper, oil painting paper, but I do have some canvas painting and another painting. Yeah, this also I painted it on a oil painting paper. Okay. Yeah. And then I show you my charcoal pencil. That's a charcoal pencil. Another charcoal here. Another charcoal pencil here. Yeah. So anyway. So if you're into portraiture, you really have to start with graphite and then move to charcoal, graphite portrait. Can you see? So this is only graphite and white chalk. The highlight is white pastel pencil. Can you see the mouth and the teeth? Yeah. So from graphite you move to charcoal, from charcoal you move to pastel. Once you're really familiar with those medium, and then you move to oil. Some artists, they just go straight to oil painting without doing any graphite or pastel, and then that's where the problem arises. So anyway, let me finish this one. Because the shadow is the very where the challenge are. Okay, if you can see how the core shadow moved from this one, it's moved there, and another one here is goes down there, and then it moves here. Okay, and then on that note, you also have the reflection here, skin reflection there. A lot of skin reflections, that's very, very important. So I'm still working on that. Thank you. Thanks for the likes. Anyway, Frida Kahlo's eyebrows are like joining in. Okay. Let me just darken that part. And then there's this hard shadow here. You have that hard shadow. There you go. Okay, and then you have the shadow here. Thank you so much. Okay, let me work on, because there's a reflection here. The hardest part is the balance between the shadow and the highlight, and these skin reflections. You have skin reflection here. That's the hardest part. Let me zoom in. So. Yeah, so I have another skin reflection here. I love these tools. It's called Shaper. It's not an eraser, it's not a brush. But this is a gum, a rubber, sorry. It's rubber. Okay, it's not a brush. It's called Shaper. What it do is, it pick up some of the pigment and it will lighten the pigment very gradually, which is I like. See? So if I want to lighten this, because there's some skin reflection on that part there. It's okay to tap the screen. If you can, just tap the screen. Show some love. So it will be better for my algorithm. Okay, let me get some. Yeah, so right now I'm just yes, and then you also have very small skin reflection on that side. And then some highlight here. Thanks for joining. Thank you so much. There you go. And then you have that very, very subtle light here. There you go. So that's why I love this shading stamp. It's called shading stamp. Okay, it's only paper actually. It comes with various sizes. Okay. And I bought it in Amazon, I think for 12 pieces for what, $8? I can push the whites. You have this really reflection there, and this one here also. Okay, so after that I just use my stamp to spread the white. Spread it. There you go. Hold on. Some more white here. Okay. Thank you so much, Maria. Thank you. I appreciate it so much. Thank you. Yeah, so right now I'm just expanding my values from light to dark, because mostly my midtones are already okay. That's how I work. If I'll do my work, I always start. Okay, I'm holding my value scale because this is very important. If I paint or if anything, I do charcoal or pastel, I always start here. Some artists, they immediately start on dark and light, okay? If they're okay with that, and then it's okay. But for me, I always start here. And that value. And then I slowly go here, go there. Then go to my dark and go to my light. And go to my darkest and to my lightest. That's how I start. That means I start on the middle. This is called middle value. Okay? And then slowly work my way to the darkest and to the lightest. So right now, I'm working on the lightest. That's why I'm adding white pastel right now. So I'm working on the lights. Okay. And then I use my stamp to blend a little bit, because I still want those pencil marks to be there. Okay. I don't want the pencil mark to be too smooth. Okay, and then this one very light here, and then also very light there. If you have a question, those who are artists that are watching, yeah, you can ask question. I'll teach. Don't worry. I like teaching. I want to share my what I know. Okay, artists, we should be helping each other. Artists support artists. We should not be fighting. We should not be like, oh, you're doing this, you're not an artist. No, I don't like that. We should unite, we should help each other, okay? I don't mind whether you're doing abstract, or you're doing impressionist, or you're doing hyperrealism, it's okay. I don't have issue with that, okay? So if you have questions on technique and on my process, okay, and who's my influence, yeah, because I have a lot of artists that influences me, living artists. Okay, there's light there. It's a highlight. See, very important. So I'm just adding now the value one, and there's like a light there. Selected, not all, so I don't want. Okay. And that's make the painting looking raw. I just want all the pencil mark remain. Okay. Right. So you can ask me questions, don't worry. I'll be finishing in 10 minutes. I'm sorry because it's already 2 a.m. here in California. Okay. Oh, no, this is a pastel pencil and pastel stick. Pastel. Hold on, it's called sanguine. It's actually red chalk. So it's a chalk. And then I also have a pastel pencil. It's pencil. But I'm using only red and black and charcoal plus white. So it's three pencil. Okay, they I don't know whether French they call it truist. Okay, truist. That means literally means three pencil. The reason is three pencil is I'm using the red, the white, and the charcoal. That's why they call it truist. Okay, so yeah, anyway, I'll be done in a few. Let me just widen my highlight. Thank you so much, Jimmy. Thank you so much. Same name, I'm also Jimmy. Thanks for the follow. Isadora, thank you so much. Thank you. So let me just spread the lights. Thanks for the likes. Thank you. Yeah, it's a very challenging art piece. Let me go back again. There's some more light there. It's nearly done. I might add some signature tomorrow. And I'm selling this portrait. So if you wanted to bid, you can DM me. There you go. Thank you. Thanks for the likes. Thank you so much. Five more minutes. Okay. Always the mistake of the artist is to make this corner pointed. It should not be pointed. See? Oh yeah, the sweat. That's called pastel matte. Yeah, that's a very expensive materials, and but I don't like doing painting on that materials. Some artists, they like it so much. That's a good materials actually. That's why it's expensive. And yeah, the pastel will really stick there. Anyway, so for the corner of the mouth, always blend. Okay, always blend. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you, Laban de Goom. Sorry, I couldn't read. Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, I'll just show you the picture, the original picture. That's her. See, I changed the clothes. Okay, I use that clothes. Okay. What I like about that is she doesn't have any earrings. Normally she had earrings, so, and then I asked my followers whether I put the earrings or not, and most of them, I did some count. Most of them suggested no need to put because it's very rare. So yeah, okay. Some of them voted, okay, you put. But when I did my counting on how many voted not to put, majority wins. So I decided, okay, don't put the earrings. Yeah. Thank you so much. It's a very challenging artwork because there's a lot of shadows. See, I don't know, sometimes I need to stop because if not, I will continue for years. Yeah, there's a lot of shadows here, there, shadows here, coarse shadows, and then we go, and then the reflection, skin reflection, and then shadows here. Okay. Shadows there, here. So from this shadow here, you have there, and then you have skin reflection, very subtle. And then you have this skin reflection here, and then you have slight shadow, dark shadow there, and then you have another skin reflection, and then you have this dark here, because underneath there will be another skin reflection, and then you have also there on that side. So it's a very, very challenging. Very challenging, you know, things to do, but I'm happy with the outcome. And for those who are interested, DM me an offer. I couldn't decide how much I'm going to sell this art piece. Yeah, you just DM me, and then the person who will give me a good offer, I'll sell it, including shipping, anywhere in the world. So I changed her clothes. Okay, let me see. Oh, it's 2 a.m. Sorry, guys. I need to... Let me just fix these lights here. Let me just sign up. Hold on, huh? Let me just... Anyway, thank you so much for the likes. Thanks for the follow. Thanks for the support. Okay. Thanks for the love. So I just follow the hair strand. That's what one of my technique. And then I don't really copy what exactly on the picture. I just love to improvise. Okay. No need to exactly copy. Okay. Improvise. It's like in music. When you play instrument, sometimes if you improvise, it's better. You learn from there, and then there's one musician who has a saying that improvisation is the genesis of composition. So that's very nice. So when I paint, I just don't copy. I interpret. I always tell that to my client. So I'm not photographic realism. I don't do that. Yeah, I don't do photographic realism as much as possible. I want to interpret the artwork based on my own observation, based on my interpretation, because painting is communication, okay? So how do you interpret what you see? Especially when you're copying picture. I'm a photographer, I know. Most of the time, the picture are not also accurate in colors, especially. So, not unless it went through a post-processing and then it's color corrected, then it's okay. But if I have a client and I couldn't do a live session on him, he will just provide picture. I'll make sure I'm going to explain the pros and cons in copying picture. So, and that's very important. So I always tell that to my student, that it's better to interpret. Don't just copy, but interpret. Same thing in singing. You cannot like copy what Whitney Houston are doing or Mariah Carey. So it's better when you sing their song is you do your own style. Maybe add some of his hairstyle, but it's also nice to interpret it the way you sing it. So same true with painting. So that's what I'm doing right now. I'm doing my own interpretation based on the picture that I have with Frida Kahlo, and then that's it. See? It's not photographic. It's not hyperrealism. Yeah, see? Correct, yeah. Do your own style. The same in painting, because painting is communication. So if you can do your own interpretation, it's better, yeah? Even though I'm copying a master copy, like I did Rembrandt and Bouguereau, some other artists, I still put my own style on the painting because I cannot copy other signature. That's Rembrandt handwriting. I cannot copy that. But I learn how he did the painting, what pigment he used, what the thought process, and then from there, I'll do my own. That's how you learn. And that's what I'm doing right now, because I'm copying Frida Kahlo based on the picture I have. And then I do my own interpretation. It's not perfect, but I think since I'm the one who make this drawing, nobody can say, oh, how come it's not correct? Okay? So, there you go. I might sign this tomorrow. Let's see. Sometimes I just skip the drawing for a while and then come back in a few days. Yeah, but I'm really happy now. I think it's okay. Yeah, thank you so much. Thanks for the likes. Let me add some more light highlight on the upper part, and then I'll declare it rest for a day. It's already 2 a.m. here in California. Okay, see? So just small lines will create that movement. Okay, even from here. Thank you so much, Robert. Thank you. Yeah, thank you so much. I really appreciate you all your comment and support. I just started this TikTok like 2 years ago, and I didn't know that I'm going to have a couple of followers that will like my artwork. So it's my therapy actually, because I lost my wife last January. So I'm still struggling until now. And I was on hiatus in painting for almost 20 years. I became busy with my full-time job, and I never painted. It's only when last May of 2020 when I came back to painting. Thank you so much, Sweet Pea. Yeah, it was a sudden when my wife died. So still struggling. That's why sometimes I don't have, you will see pine up that sometimes I don't go live. This is only my fourth time in 2 years. And still break my heart, because she's my number one fan. Oh yeah, thanks Maria. Yeah, I know. Yeah, but I need more light on top there. Some more white. This is a white pastel pencil, because the light here, that's the strongest. So I have to really push the light. See? I miss her. I miss my wife. We've been married for almost 30 something years. Some more here, some more. Yeah, so actually, painting, most artists, I think Ingres, painting is one-third drawing. And that's true. If you want to portraiture and you don't know how to draw, your painting will be useless. If you want to portraiture, okay? I'm talking about portraiture. I think even though you want to paint flowers, still life, then if you don't know how to draw, not unless you're abstractionist, you're into abstract, then that's different. But if you're on a realism or even impressionism, if you don't know how to draw, this drawing is very important. Okay, let me blend that. That's bad. There you go. Thanks, Sammy. Thank you so much. Yeah. And the fact that it's only red, basically it's red, black, and white. So I'm only using three colors. You see, that's why important for an artist to understand values. Understand values, okay? Yeah, it's not about color, no. Color is secondary. I'm using only red, and if you see charcoal, that's charcoal. That's only charcoal. That's only black. And the play here is how to balance your values and your drawing. Okay? This is charcoal. Some artists will just start doing painting without understanding values. Another charcoal. That's good, yeah. Because painting is also expression, how you express. Even though you're doing like portraiture, but if you can get the person expression, then you're also delivering what's the message of the picture. Okay, so that's very important. Yeah, like for this one, the softness of the page, the edges, the highlight. If you see all my edges, it's all soft. Can you see? It's all blur. Huh? See? It's all broken. See? See that edges? It's all broken. There's no sharp edges. Okay, that's keep the artwork another level of atmosphere. Okay, another level of space. Okay, and then what I normally do even in painting, if there's a light here and there's a shadow here, I'll make my background darker here and lighter there. So if you can see, it's darker on this side because that's where the light is coming, and then I'll make this lighter. That's my own style. I learned it from old masters. See? So I just darken that side. Okay. Yeah, it's Frida, yes. But it's a different Frida because she doesn't have any earrings. So Marie Frida has always earrings and choker. But this one is different. I'm from California. Okay, so my edges are all soft. There's no sharp edges. Everything is soft. Yeah, mine is stone paper. This is Canson. That's stone paper. Warm gray. Okay? Warm gray. It depends on my subject. If my subject are European, I'm going to use a cold gray. But if my subject are the skin tone are olive or Asian, then, or Chinese. Yes, mitiente. Mitientes, yes. That's my paper. I use that for my charcoal, my pastels. Yeah. So, and mitiente has two sides, okay? The other side is more rough. more textured. The other side is a little bit smoother. So I'm using this smoother side, depends on the size of the portrait. But for this portrait, like the size, I'm using the smoother side. If I'm doing a bigger portrait, then I'm using the other side. Okay. Yeah, so I'm using both pastel pencil and my pastel Rembrandt. Okay. I also love new pastels. Okay. And I also have Sennelier, which is really very, very strong pigment. Sennelier. This is very, very strong pigment. I like it. Sennelier. Very strong. So I save this on the last part of the painting. Very pigmented. I like it so much. So that's it. That's the way I do it. So I just repeat it that I don't only copy, I interpret. Okay, I'm not photorealistic. I cannot do that. I hope I can. I'm more on traditional, classical realism. Okay, so wow. Yeah, I mix it, but because this is only three colors, red, black, and white. So I start with the red, all red, and then slowly adding the black and the white. Okay, so there's no really mixing on this style. If I do colored pastel, I'll show you. For this one, that's colored. Okay. There you go. For the color, then I mix, but basically I start with orange ochre. I just mix red ochre and yellow ochre. Then I add a little bit of black. It's like painting. That's color. That's full color. Okay. And that's original. My one of my original. Let me bring out the picture so you will see how I. Okay. So. That's the original picture of her without the laurel. I just added the laurel, and then the concept I copied like from that, almost similar concept. And then I just remember these clothes, okay? I changed the clothes. Okay? I changed it. So this is actually a Filipina dress. I changed it to national clothes of the Philippines, Filipina dress. And then I added, there's two worlds here. This is Europe, and that's Philippines. Because the title of this painting is Mestiza. Mestiza, in Philippines, when we say Mestiza, is European and Asian. That married. So once they got a child, they called it Mestiza. So that's why the title of this painting is Mestiza. Okay, so and this lady is one of my followers in Instagram. Her name is Nazli. Okay, that's her. So when I saw her picture, I told her, okay, Nazli, can I paint you? Oh yeah, okay. So that's how it's all started. Okay, I haven't finished it. Yeah. So that's how I work. This is colored. So I mix it. Although in the Rembrandt, it already had some blessed ochre, but I love mixing. It's like oil painting. So I just mix red and yellow, red ochre and yellow ochre. And then I added a little bit of gray to, because the skin tone is orange plus gray, okay? Or else it's high chroma. You cannot use orange straight, so you have to add a little bit of gray in your orange, then you put your white. So, but this one, because pastel is transparent, so I don't add white. I might add white on the highlights. So this is full color. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, so closer. There's no really sharp edges. See, my edges are, they are blur. You can still see the pencil. Can you see the pencil there? So that's how I work. That's how I paint also. I try not to really sharpen everything. In photography, we call it depth of field. Okay. I haven't finished this one. I'll try to mold the paste and maybe darken some parts. So anyway, just to show you. And then some of my paintings and another paintings on paper. Yeah, but right now I don't have time in doing prints. I might. I was thinking of that also. My charcoal pencil, this is charcoal on paper. That's why value is important. It's not really color. If you're going to ask me which is important, color or value. Value is important. See, this is black only. That's only red. Okay, if your values are wrong and you don't know how to draw, then that's a problem. Yeah, I might think about prints, but I'm busy. I'm doing a lot of painting for my exhibit next year. That's why. So I suppose I have exhibit on June. So. Yeah, I like to, because I already have a company who's will be doing the print, scan the artwork, and print my original, because I have a couple of originals that I can print and people will buy. So yeah, I might go there. So, but anyway, thank you so much. Right now I have 29. Thank you so much. I have to go. It's already like 2:26 here in California. Thank you so much. Okay. Okay. Bye bye. It's 2:30 now. I still don't know. We haven't discussed the details. It's supposed to be this year. But because of COVID, it's already been postponed for 2 years now. So they haven't called me back yet. It's a group exhibition here in LA. 8 of us. So yeah, if it pushes through, then I'll do a live streaming on my Facebook and even here. Yeah. Anyway, I have to go. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Just check on me tomorrow. Tomorrow I might do some paintings tomorrow. Not this one. I'm doing an oil painting. You can check my video, my latest video. I'm doing this lady that I'm started painting. Okay, so thank you so much. Thanks for the likes. Thanks for the follow. I'm sorry if you couldn't understand my accent. I wasn't born here. So nice to meet you also, Maria. Thanks for the question. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.